Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today, continuing with the prone engineering series, we are going to do a fine tuning, instruction fine tuning in this case of a model. The model we are going to use is a Flantified. For those that are following my channel, I already explained this model, but anyway, I will give you a reference. You have all the links on the notebook. The T5 is a model designed by Google, and the series, the FLAN series, the model has been fine-tuned for a mixture of tags. This fine-tune has been done with the FLAN dataset. I give you as well a reference. What is the FLAN dataset? At the same time, FLAN dataset is a collection of the dataset with a design to fine-tune models for multiple tags, doing prone engineering and prone fine-tuning. In our case, we are going to use another dataset for specialize this model in dialog summarization. In document summarization, we will use this dataset, DialogSum, which is a model also designed for that purpose, to personalize, to do fine tuning in dialog summarization. So, what is including the dataset? You can see here there is a three success trains, validation, and test. Every sample, every row contains the dialogue. It's a dialogue in between usually two persons. Some cases is three, but well, usually two persons about a topic, and then on there is a summary done by a human being. And then we will be using this to train, to fine tune the Flantified for doing the summaries of the test as much as possible as the human being have been doing. We will be doing this in a Colab Pro instance with a GPU A100. We will need to take the base version of the Flantified, which contain 250 million of parameters. Because here we are not doing any reduction of the number of parameters that we are going to try. We are going to try to train the whole model. In posterior tutorials, we will do some other techniques this is matter for other tutorial. Today, in this tutorial, we will use the whole model. We will fine tune the whole model. That's why we need to take one of the modest versions, if you want to say that, no? The 250 million parameters. Okay, let's start. We install the libraries we need. I already run the notebook, so we will go quickly through them. I'm on the drive. I download these utilities from 1DB. For those that follow my channel, also I already introduced what is 1DB. 1DB is a platform where you can log and all the steps and artifacts and history of the experiments that you are doing, very similar to MLflow. For those that are familiar with MLflow, you will find that is pretty similar. The concept is exactly the same, but well, in with another look and feel. And also this guy software, weight and biases, designed this to help and fine tune LLMs specifically, and then it is probably more orientated to that matter. But well, in any case, you can do exactly the same with MLflow, but I prefer to use this because well, it's again designed for that purpose, to fine tune or to train LLMs. You can, if you go to the look to the UI, you just simply work you have some projects. Inside the project you have runs, you can log the artifacts, you can go to the specific runs and see what happened during the training or validation of the model. Well, again, very similar to to what you can do with MLflow, but with another look and feel. Okay. Here I initialize the project. I already had done some experiments in this folder with this inflantified LoRa. You will see that I use the same project for also LoRa and QLoRa fine tuning, but again this is purpose of another tutorial. We load the libraries that we need to create the model, to load the model and the tokenizer, the base model. Here we just download the model for Hugging Face, from Hugging Face, the dialog zone. Originally the model had three partitions, train, dataset and test. Well, here this split is slightly small, but okay, it's fine. If you want to do another partition, it's up to you. You can concatenate the datasets and do another partition. It's up to you. I will continue with this split that isn't good enough for me. Here I transform the dataset to pandas, and then I serialize the dataset to 1 dB. We can follow here. The run is here, so it's the run. So you will see here that, yeah, simply what we are doing is simply uploading the data set in pandas format. Okay. Here we download the model from Hugging Face as well. This is the base model, the flantified base version. We use classes. This, as you probably remember from other tutorials, we need to use these classes from Hugging Face. These are generic classes to load the sequence-to-sequence compatible models. This is a generic class that is classes that for any model that fall in this category, but where we can use the generic class because it's gonna work. This class is designed to load all models that fall in or can be categorized in sequence to sequence or for when you are going to do sequence to sequence training. We load the tokenizers, the instantiate the tokenizer as well, also with the generic class. Here we just count the number of parameters. I designed this function to count the number of parameters that we will reduce using LoRa and QLoRa, but well, we just here to confirm that we had the 250 million parameters. We are not going to reduce anything here. We here just create a table. We are going to do some tests with three examples of the train dataset, sorry, the test dataset. And then we just take three random examples, and then we do short inference, zero short inference. So this we just send the prompt to the model, and we see what the model return. Then we will compare at the end of the process, at the end of the fine tune, zero shot with the model, with the fine tuning model, using the metrics roads. I also put you a reference of what roads is doing. It's also a metric designed to evaluate models, especially for summarization or machine translation tasks. And then we will see how it was. We will give some explanations how roads is designed and how you can interpret the roads metric. We just simply here push the table to 1 dB. We prepare our tokenizer. As you remember, these tokenizers you need to path every prompt to the max length. Max length is the biggest, the longest prompt that you had on the data set, and then on the processes are smaller, you padded with a you padded to the maximum length. The same, this is for prompts and this is for labels. Labels you do the same. The labels that have the summaries, that on the human who make the summaries of the of these dialogues. Also, we look for the max, the longest summary, and we pad all the labels to the max length with with a token. The same that we did from the for the prompts. And then on here we are just doing this tokenization for the test, train, and validation datasets. And then on here we remove the unnecessary columns. And finally, what we have on tokenized dataset, this is a collection of the a dictionary of datasets. We have just the input, this is our token, our embedding of the dialogue, and here the embedding of the labels. We upload as well the tokenizer datasets to OneDB. We just here just control that we had the same. Well, it's obvious, but okay, just make a print of the size of the datasets and the name of the of the features, input IDs and labels, and here we just simply create an object simply namespace to include all the parameters that we are going to use for training. Let's take a look at the learning rate, accumulate gradients every 2 steps, 20 epochs, shape evaluate shape strategy and evaluation strategy per step. So this means that every 1000 steps we will do an evaluation using the Val dataset. We use a warming 500 steps of warming. This will be using the maximum learning rate at the beginning, just to to motivate the model to learn. Number of the checkpoints, maximum 3. So we set only the 3 best models in checkpoints folder. And at the end of the training, in this case fine tuning, we set the best model to memory. We just create with the namespace class the training argument class, and we create the trainer original model arguments and the tokenizer dataset, train tokenizer dataset, and validation dataset. We run the trainer, and it's here 15,000 steps, and the trainer automatically load the logs to FlanDB. We can take a look here. So what's going on here in our training? You have here the Val training, etc. The statistics. Then on here, I'm just taking the best model checkpoint, which in this case, as we started here or configure this parameter, is going to be matching the also the model that I had the training loaded in memory. So we just serialize this and set the model to a custom path. Later on we are going to, in this case, we upload it to a S3 bucket. Here we are not gonna do it. Remove this dependency. What I wanted to show you here is that the model is 1 gigabit of memory. So with this, well, not bad. It's a small model in comparison with others that we saw in previous tutorials. This model is relatively small, and well, you can run it in a GPU, even without GPU for inference, but well, it's gonna be slow, but you can do it, no? We offload the model to 1DB, so just to keep track as well. It's also, as I said before, you can use 1DB to for model repository, and then on version the version your models keep track of all your experiments. You want, if we want to hear, you can go to artifacts, and as you see here, we have our instruction model. We had the latest, and here, well, this is a version of the PET, the LoRa version of the same model. But we will see this later. Here you have the history of all the runs, and here we have tables. So all the artifacts that you are producing in your during your experiments can be saved here, and then you can recover this similarly as we do with MLflow. You just download the model, you point to the name of the model and to the tag, in this case latest or B0, and you download the model to your environment. We move the model to, we instantiate we load our extracted model, our fine-tuning model, using the same classes as the base one, and we don't extract the tokenizer because it's exactly the same. We don't need to do it again. We are just going to pass the same prompts through the instructed model, but the tokenizer, it doesn't change. We didn't touch the weights on the tokenizer. We move it to the GPU, and here we do the same example than before, but in this case we pass through the zero shot, the same that we did in the previous evaluation. This is a qualitative evaluation, but we will do it later with the ROADS metric. And then you can see here, you can compare yourself what the model is doing. Here is the baseline, the original model, and the extracted model. Here we are just printing the three exact examples that we had up, and then on we load these examples to 1DB as we did before. We offload ROADS, the metric, and we move the model, the original model, to the GPU as well, and we evaluate the model, both models, no? So the original model, we are getting ROADS 1, ROADS 2, ROADS L, and ROADS LSUM. You can take a look here of what means ROADS 1, ROADS 2, L, and W. This is first using 1 gram, and the one ROADS 2 is using B grams, 2 grams, and the other longest common sequence is self-explanatory, what they are saying, and the W means waiting LCS, is a version of the ROADS L. So, well, you can use simply ROADS 1 and ROADS 2. It will give you a graph of if the model already improved or not using the fine-tune. So zero shot, we are getting a 0.20. So this to understand this metric as closest to one, the best, no? So zero shot is getting is 0.20, and ROADS 2 0.09, 18, 18. Those two are pretty similar, and then you can see here how we improve the values using so doing inference with the structured model. So meaning that obviously the process improve the ability of the model to do summarization. We do the same here with the whole data set, and finally we just offload these metrics to 1DB. And that's all. We offload the table, and we offload the metrics to 1DB for future reference. Later on, we will compare as well how performance de PIF, de parameter efficient fine tuning in comparison with instruction fine tuning, we will see that there is a slightly less improvement using PIF. But well, in many cases, we are going to choose that training because, as you see here, to train a prompt using prompt fine tuning is quite expensive in terms of resources. You need to have very powerful GPUs. This is very small model, but if you plan to use another models like Mistral or Falcon, this process take a lot of time because essentially we are fine tuning the whole model. This model, as you see, is very small. The training here took, let me remember, probably took, 1 hour 29 minutes, so it's nothing. But yeah, it's 250 million parameters, which at the same time is very small model. In any case, we are already getting an improvement from zero shot with just done simple model. Obviously, if we take a bigger version, or even a bigger version of the FLAN, we will need a bigger, obviously, more resources to fine-tune the model. And obviously we will get even better outcomes. But well, just this is to show you how we can improve the numbers, the metrics of the model during the fine tuning. And for that purpose, in considering the resources that we have at hand, this is well, a good output what we get here. And that's all. We see in next tutorials. And then if you like the content, please give me a like and subscribe to the channel if you didn't do it before. Thank you.